Hi everyone, Sandy here from Everyday Penny Productions, Everyday Penny on Everything Money. Today we're going to play a game. It's kind of a flashcard game. The boys are going to pick a card. They're going to tell me the definition of the word that's on there. If they get it right, they get to pick another card. If they get it wrong, then their opponent gets their chance to pick a card. The winner of this game will have the most cards that they've answered correctly, and they will get a prize of $10. Okay, are we ready to play?
Oh, money.
All right.
I go first.
Who's going first?
Me. Rock, paper, scissors.
Well, he already called rock, paper, scissors.
That was only two times.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
I win. Okay. Overdrawn account.
Overdrawn account.
What do you think that means?
You spent too much money in your account, and now you don't have any money in your account, and you owe the bank money.
Does the bank charge you fees?
Yeah.
Yes, and the bank charges you fees for that. A pretty hefty fee, too.
So okay. I get to go again?
You get to go again.
Health insurance.
You obviously know this one.
It's insurance in which you pay for your health in case something goes wrong.
It pays the hospital?
It pays the hospital, it pays doctors, it pays for your well visits and your sick visits. And
well, he didn't get it right either.
He didn't get it right either. I'm going to take that one. Because neither one of you got that exactly right.
You're
Well, that's another health insurance.
Why is there two?
I don't know.
Passive income. When you get money for doing nothing, pretty much.
Right. So when you invest money.
Yeah, and you just get passive income from, like, investments and stocks. Mm.
This one you're going to fail on, too.
Right. Or interest.
Yeah, so I basically got that right.
Right. Or interest from the bank. So you go for the next one.
So, life insurance. Well, that's definitely the insurances. So life insurance, it ensures that your life will never not leave your body until you actually like just die from old age.
Alright, that's wrong.
You answer. What's life insurance?
I don't know. That's why I'm saying it's wrong.
Okay, life insurance. Let me explain.
Why do you have to do?
Life insurance is for the people you leave behind. In my policy. Would be given to you so that you can continue to live your life the way you know it. You love.
Question. Is this just random stuff? Like random
it's
stuff?
It's random stuff about money, yes.
Mom, you go?
Oh, was
so
this yours?
Risk?
No, this was Jack's.
No, that's yours. You're not playing?
Did you go?
No,
it's your turn.
He's giving. We're supposed to be playing against each
okay,
other.
Okay, a loan is when you want money from the bank. So you could have money for something, but you have to pay them back.
Basically,
and it's an interest rate.
Right. Yeah, I get to
and
keep
the
it.
Longer you don't pay it off, the more money you have to pay.
Right.
So that's
risk
how that's how
game.
Banks make money.
Risk is a game. Well, yeah.
Maybe we didn't learn this, so.
Well, what kind of financial risks could there be?
You go broke. You go broke. Spend too much money and you go broke. You have to live on the streets.
And what's
and oh, if you put money in stock,
right.
Then you have a risk of losing money.
And so there's what kind of risk? There's market risk, right? But it's risk with the company because things can happen, restructuring or something can happen there. And so that's going to be some risk.
Yeah.
There's liquidity risk, meaning are you going to be able to liquidate your stock and take that at a gain? Or is there the risk of a loss? So there's a lot of different kinds of risk. And we're going to talk about risk more in a different video. But, all right, we'll give that to you. What you got?
Stock exchange. I don't know that at all.
All right, Zach.
Stock
exchange, pass to you.
So stock exchange is when stocks basically exchange with their, like, products and stuff. Right?
No.
The stock exchange is kind of like a place where stocks trade, but changing the ownership of stock. Do you see the difference? It was close. It was close. You know what? We're going to give that to him because you didn't have risk all the way together.
Yes, I did.
I didn't.
No, you didn't. All right. Wait. We gave that to him so he gets to go again.
It's the same one.
Okay.
I can say the same thing.
Go ahead.
Bank.
Banks. Banks are places that they store money.
Now I get that
and
one too.
No, they don't. It's where they store money and you can put money in there. And that's where you take loans from.
You
can
okay,
also get
that's
some
good.
I got mutual funds. Mutual funds are like a batch of cookies, kind of. Like, it takes a little time for them to bake, right?
Right, it takes time for them to bake. But what in a batch of cookies are there?
There's different ingredients.
Different ingredients. So what would a mutual fund have?
Funds.
Maybe stocks.
Stocks.
Maybe bonds.
Yeah, stock bonds.
Yeah, next card.
I have so many cards.
Next card. Hurry
Can
up.
Can I go now?
No.
Not yet. He didn't get it wrong.
He's gonna
currency.
Currency. Currency is like the amount of money like you're able to spend. It's kind of like a budget.
Hold
currency.
On. Hold
nope,
on.
Currency is not that.
Currency is money.
It's money. It's very
yeah,
simple.
Money.
This
it's just money.
This is currency.
Yeah, currency.
Okay.
$100 bills, $1 bills, $10 bills, $2 bills, $20 bills.
No.
Go ahead.
Beta.
Beta.
What's beta? Do you know what beta is?
Yeah,
beta
is like yeah, beta testing. Like
video
games. Early access.
Like,
no.
I don't know any of this.
Neither one of you got beta right. Beta is risk. It's a measurement of systematic risk in the stock market and with a stock. So a stock's beta is a measurement of its risk compared to the stock market. Trading. What's it mean? You know.
Trade spices for gold.
I can say what trading is.
No, you can't because
trading.
I didn't say what it is yet.
No, bad boy.
Savings.
No, bad boy.
I let him have that one. That's an easy one.
Bad.
Go.
Okay, you save money.
And where do you save money?
Bank.
In the bank or your piggy bank
Skunks.
Or somewhere. What's the point
or
of saving?
In your dog.
So you have more money in the future.
Right, and you don't spend it, Mr. Spender.
I'm not the Mr. Spender.
Okay, put that in your go ahead. Next one.
Exchange trade fund. What? How do you expect me to know this?
It's trading.
That's
but
it.
He knows everything because he's in every video.
You're exchanging.
He likes it.
And you're trading funds.
No, it's ETF or exchange traded fund, and what that is a basket of stocks. So all different company stock in one fund, and it's kind of like a mutual fund. The stocks within a certain segment. And it's like a mutual fund.
I
so nobody got that one.
I know none of those.
All right, go ahead.
Dakota's a happy doggo.
Your turn. Because he didn't get it. What's this
Cyber
one?
Monday.
Cyber Monday.
Dakota, did you ram your head into that wall? Cyber Monday?
He doesn't know.
Okay, Cyber Monday is like the Monday after a holiday when a lot of the stores have a sale. Cyber Monday.
How am I supposed to know that?
How?
That was NASDAQ. The NASDAQ is where a lot of the tech funds trade, a lot of the tech stocks trade, okay?
Wait, look at my finger.
And it's an electronic system of trading. It's all computers, NASDAQ. What do you got there, Jack? Renter's insurance, that's easy. Items got damaged, you would use your renter's insurance to help replace those items. All right, next one.
How are we supposed to know this stuff?
Well, let's see.
I shouldn't know it at
We're
all.
We're certainly learning, right?
Lending.
Lending, what's that mean?
You're lending like money or
Why
like, stocks?
Easy ones.
You get to like lend your money to a friend or your stocks to a friend or anything to your
right.
to people. Like
well, you
lending wouldn't... or how, like lending like some of your furniture or something?
Well, it's like what a bank does with a loan. They
yeah.
lend. All right, next. Jack, your turn. Come on.
What?
That $10 is on the table, dude.
Why are you giving us
no any of this?
Credit report. What's a credit report?
I have no idea.
I think your credit
is.
It's telling you what your credit is and like how much like debt you have on it because it's like a credit report. It's reporting to you the status on your, what the status is on your credit.
A credit report's like a report card. Like when you go to school and you get A, B's, and C's, right?
Yeah, so I got this right.
Yeah, but it's numbers. It's from 300 to 850 and yeah. is on your credit report.
So you want to have a higher.
A higher. 850 yeah, higher. Is good. Higher is better. Go ahead.
Hey, hey, hey. No. The penis or loser?
Pick two. Philanthropist.
What the hell?
You don't know what a philanthropist is. No. Barter. Barter's easy.
Oh, barter. I know.
No. He doesn't get this.
Barter. I know barter.
What do you think?
I know barter.
Have something.
Firing is
no.
just fair.
No.
Right.
Like,
it's like
one thing. Like, you try to, like, get them to...
Zach, you weren't given permission to speak.
All right, you guys don't need to argue. Bartering.
So I got that right.
No. You don't get it because you interrupted me.
What were you going to say, Jack?
I wasn't going to say anything.
So, yeah, I got that.
Okay, listen.
I got barter.
Bartering is...
You can barter, like, giving, like, example, like, you can sell your cow for, like, two pigs or three pigs.
Right. He kind of got that one, Jack. All right, what do we have?
Yeah, so give
Go
me
ahead, Zach.
Give me barter.
No.
If I find a double one this one...
All right, no one's going to get this next one. This one... is FINRA. And FINRA is the organization that oversees all the financial markets and all the people who work within the financial markets. It's the regulatory organization, FINRA.
And Mom, keep in mind that Jack has one less and I have one more than what I actually have because he took one of mine that I got.
Hold on. That one he wouldn't have gotten, so then he would fail, so then it would be my turn, so.
Okay, I love the fact that you guys like to compete, but...
But it's my turn.
Let's make it happen. Go.
Okay.
All right, what part?
I picked up auto insurance. It's insurance that pays for your car if you get in an accident with your car. So, yeah, I win.
Right. It pays if you get into an accident, and it pays for the repairs on your car.
Yeah.
Right? So that you can get back on the road. And sometimes they give you a loaner car, too, with your insurance. You can get a loaner car.
Oh, yeah, you can get, like, a car that you have to use until the older one gets fixed.
Go ahead.
Charitable giving. You can give food to, like, people who need it. Like the charity, like at homeless shelters, you could give them like some of your stuff.
Right, so charitable giving also goes with philanthropists. If you're a person who is doing charitable work, you're doing philanthropy.
Yay.
Okay, next.
Credit card. Okay, credit card, it stores your money on a card. Yeah.
I just want to quickly check something.
You swipe it. That's what a credit card
your
is.
Card is. But your money isn't really there.
Yeah, it's
you're using
it's
the
in
bank's
the, it's
money.
In the, yeah, that's what I was gonna say. It's in the bank, and you put in a number. You put in the number from the card, so it takes money from the bank, puts it on the card, and then you buy the thing you want.
Okay, but it's not your money.
Yeah, it is.
No.
Whose money is it?
It's the bank's money.
But is that your money from the bank?
No, that would be a debit card. If it was a debit card, it would be your money within your bank account. A credit card is just money from the bank that you're borrowing. It's like a loan. And the credit card company, which is usually a bank, will pay for your purchases for you. And then you're going to pay them back, right? With?
The money.
With?
Credit cards.
Interest. So you're going to pay back the money that you borrowed plus additional money.
I said credit cards.
Sorry. Okay. All right, Zach, you can do the next one.
Stock. Stocks are like selling of products and shipping depots where they sell the stuff, but they're part of a company. They're like in a company and you can buy ownership and get a cut of the money from it.
Right, so a stock is ownership in a company.
Boop.
Alright. So
ooh,
you have
budget. Budget is like you're on like a strict cash like restraint, so you can't spend that much cash, and you're on like a budget that if you spend too much you won't be able to pay like rent or something.
Well, a budget is what you put together so that you can pay all the things that you need to pay.
And so you don't go bankrupt.
Right, so you don't go bankrupt. And you can make that plan. A budget is a plan of spending money.
I'm not going to know what this one is.
All right, Cap M. Cap M is capital asset pricing model, and it's a way of deciding what you would like to pay price-wise for a company stock, and we'll go into that at a later video. Go ahead, Jack.
Paycheck.
All right.
Yeah.
You know what that is?
Okay, so it's you have a piece of paper, and you write the amount of money you want on it, and then you write your name.
That's a check. That's not a paycheck.
Yeah.
No, paycheck's what you get from the company you work for when you have a job. It's your paycheck. It's your weekly or bi-weekly pay.
You get like a check that has their name on it going to you with your name on it.
Right. It's an exchange
of money.
And they
write the amount of money they're paying you.
Right, correct.
Wow, I just got both of them mixed up real good.
You kind of did.
So did I get that one?
No, you don't get that one. I get it.
No, you don't.
All right. But you get the pick because he didn't really get that right.
Okay.
No. Zach gets the
pick. It's the same one.
Oh, okay.
Checking. Like checks?
Checking account. Like, what's a checking account? A
checking account is when you, like, write stuff on checks. It's a checking account where you can, like, probably, like, withdraw.
Not at all.
What's the difference between a checking account and a savings account?
A checking account, you use checks.
Right.
And savings account, you put cash in, usually.
Well, you put money in both accounts.
Yes. Yeah,
so savings account is to save
money,
and checking account is to
usually spend
to use to pay your bills.
Yeah, spend.
Okay, and they both are at the
bank,
and you get them both at a bank. Okay, I'll give you that.
Stockbroker, when the stock goes broke.
No, stockbroker is a person. Oh. Stockbroker is the person who you may call for advice on stock, or they may be the person you call to make a trade for you and to buy company stock is a stockbroker. Go ahead, Jeff.
Debit. Okay, so this is when you take money from your account and
debt.
Put it on your card.
Doesn't that say debt?
Does it say debt or debit?
It says debt.
What's debt?
Oh, you owe money to someone.
Yeah, that's when...
I still got it.
You owe money. Okay, all right, let's have the next one.
MTA. Oh, ATM.
MTA.
What's an ATM?
You take money from an ATM. Like,
and what does ATM stand for, do you know?
I think it's
automatic.
No, I didn't get to the guess yet. Automatic.
Right.
Turbulence machine.
automatic.
Teller.
Teller.
Mm-hmm. Teller.
That's it. Teller.
Yeah. It's teller
machine.
Teller machine. Yeah.
Oh.
ATM.
Okay.
Disability insurance. You know
what okay. Say you're in a wheelchair.
That's a disability.
Yeah, that's a disability.
If they
you can't walk.
And you get insurance.
You get money because you can't do other things that other people can do.
And also you get a handicap sign kind of
or
you
do
disability.
Disability is when you can't do your job
correctly.
Or you can't do.
And they give you money from the government.
Well, that's Social Security disability. Disability insurance might be a temporary disability. You might not be disabled for a long time, but you might have a short-term disability and or a long-term disability.
Loss.
You're fine. Okay.
Piggy bank. Let me go get one. Piggy bank You can store money in here. It has my name on it, by the way.
And
you can store money in here, so you keep earning money, and you could put it in here to save it up. So it's a piggy bank.
You mainly put quarters.
And then you can eventually smash it with a hammer to get your money out. But that not with this one.
All right, well, just put it down. We'll let you be the winner, because you are. You're $10, and you have your PS4 controllers back to play a different game. All right, so thank you everyone for watching. I will be going over the definitions on some of these other financial words in our other videos. So please stay tuned and keep watching us.
And this was
Zach. Bye.
Go ahead, Jackie. Say bye.
This was Zach. Bye. And on Everyday Penny Productions. Have a good day.
I'm Jack. And then Kadoodle.